Hi, we're back. I'm Mayo, your art teacher. We're doing the third lesson, the four horses of the apocalypse today. And today we're adding the fighting angels. And they'll be carried by blackbirds, my favorite. We have everything here we need. The palette today consists of your warm colors, burnt sienna, raw umber, yellow ochre, flesh, a little bit of red, cool colors on the other side of the palette. We have our cobalt, our very dark black, ivory, and our titanium white. So this is the palette today. And we're going to start by putting in the angels. We are using glaze again. It's the, again, alkyoid glazing medium, ready to use. And we're dipping our brush in a little bit of turpentine and then the glaze. I'm going to try to get out of your view here. There we go. We're going to start with the babies. They are angels. I did chalk a little bit in. Remember, a baby's head is rather large. And they're warriors. They're angels and they're warriors. We're going to the flesh tone. Putting in the arm, the head, the back. Babies have large, very large, a lot of rolls. We all know that. They're beautiful for that reason alone. Like little cherubs. We're going to put that down. Using very tiny brushes today. You can see it. And we're going to put the blackbird in. I have a couple references of blackbirds, so I think on this one, he's going to be flying another way. Not sure I like that one, but I like this one he's carrying. So I'm using my bird book, and I'm going to put the bird in his wings. Very long one here, this tip right here. They go shorter as they go out, and like that, a little bit more glaze. So let's look at it like this, and we're going to do this part of the bird where it turns in and all the way to here. And let's see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, about 12 wings hanging. So we're going to do 1, 2, and they shorten 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Baby sitting here. Birds here. And then we're going to put the bird in. So I'm going to, baby is sitting here and the bird wing is over here. And it goes back, long first. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, a little bit of glaze. We'll leave that gray showing. Baby is sitting on the bird. Or excuse me. The cherub. Then we're going to turn him this way a little bit. So we're going to put this part here, the back of the bird, and of course the wing. I'm dipping in glaze again. And we're going to go back. Let's see here. I'm going to make the bird's tail. Dip in a little terpenoid. Bring it back some more. And we got the baby sitting on the bird. Here, I'm going to put the head right about here. And he's riding the bird. And there's the arm. Got a good tip on this brush. Good. And he's going to be holding on here. And then here. So I'm putting the bird in. A little bit of the white. You can just make those wings turn. Like that. And here. Nice and slow. This is our details. Back into the black, ivory. We'll just do the glaze too. It keeps the colors. So it's workable when you have the glaze. See? A little bit more white here. Slow. I like this wing here. And here. And here, and here, and we have this part of the wing that extends out like that. Rinse our little brush off, and then we're going to put the baby in. We're dipping in a little bit of the yellow ochre, and the raw sienna. We're going to put the leg here as it goes back here. Now the glaze, if you notice, I'm looking at the bird at the same time. I'll put the bird book down now. And what I'm going to do here, I'm going to go back in with the flesh tone and bring his hip up and then his leg down in here. Probably going to bring his back up. And then the head's here. Babies have big heads. We're going to put the leg here. So I am going to reposition her. So we're going to take a little bit of the black, ivory black and the titanium, and reposition her arm, the baby's arm, and the neck, and the shoulder. Clean it off a little. We have a little baby here I was using because I love, look at that. It's a good reference. Don't think I'm crazy, I am. You don't have to think I'm crazy, I am crazy. So we're gonna put in the black here and the head here. So it's just the glazing liquid helps you. It's a mix, it's a workable medium. So you can work. We're going to put this back in the terpenoid and clean that, and then we'll just come in here and just blend a little bit. We have a sword here, but we necessarily don't need it. I'll blend into the horse here a little bit, and I got the top of the bird's head pretty good. So now I'll just put in the leg. Put that back into the terpenoid for a second. Clean your brush. Go back into the clean glaze and get some more of that flesh tone. And we're going to look at this little guy here. So we have a thigh here, the knee, the leg, and the foot. The bird's carrying her. A little bit more of the glazing medium. Put these colors in. The foot. More glazing medium to keep those colors separated. A little bit of the yellow ochre. The raw sienna. I'm going to put the arm up like this. Like that. A little bit more glazing liquid. Put it right in there. We're going to make that back more like this. And the head bigger. Like that. But we can just move this. Take another brush I have here and just swipe that out a little bit. And back. I don't mind that part. We'll keep that brush for swiping. We'll put our little angels in, so I'm going to take this cleaner brush that's sitting in the terpenoid waiting for me. We're going to go back to the flesh tone and a little bit of the yellow ochre, and we're going to put in the fighting arm back into flesh tone, and then the head. But the head's going to be looking up, so I wanted to change that position as you saw before and make the head looking up. We won't have to worry about the other arm now. So if we want the head looking up, get that other brush out of your terpenoid, go back into your ivory black, and make it look more like that. See how you can work that? So we're getting a cherub, angel, baby into the picture. I'm putting on a little titanium white for the back of the head right now. Go in your glaze. It keeps the oils workable so you can spread your colors over wet colors. I think 2 days ago, I did this already. And it was actually the first day of fall, the 23rd. So today, I believe it's the 25th. Get his big leg in there, a little foot. Just a cherub. So I want him very, very dipping there again, the glaze and the turpentine. I just want him very, the construction of a baby. We'll put his little hand in. Now we're going to put in a little bit of burnt sienna, the red brown for the tush, the fat back. Babies have fat backs. We have the hip here. Now if we dip in our, right into our medium, our glaze, we can do the little bit of the shadows we need. They have round, roly-poly necks. Dip right back into the burnt sienna. A little bit here. So we have one cherub, angel, baby fighting the horses that are up above. I put a little titanium white here. We'll probably put some back in here. Now go back into the glaze. Don't forget, the glaze keeps it workable. I'm going to do a little bit of the yellow ochre with a flesh tone and a little bit of the titanium white. Again, dip in the blaze. Glaze. So welcome back. Today is the 25th of September. Fall is here. And there's our cherub. If anything, I go back in the glaze with a little highlight of white. Yeah. Put the baby in. Big tush. Babies have those beautiful round tushes. And they have that fat on their back. I love it. Who doesn't love a baby, right? And then looking up for the fight. Even if we went a little bit like that. Then, I'm going to put that brush into the terpenoid bottle. Go back into the nice ivory black. And just put some of this in underneath. My favorite are blackbirds. So we're doing our blackbirds today. Fix that wing a little bit. A little bit more feeling here. I love blackbirds. And then back into the glaze with a little bit of the black. We can keep this going on the tail. And a little here. A longer one there. Yeah, nice feeling in the blackbird. Let's clean this brush, drop it into the terpenoid, swipe it clean, go back into the ivory black, and just add a little bit more here. I'm on an angle, so bear with me. Painting straightforward is a lot easier than an angle, but we have to do what we have to do if we're taking a video of our painting. There we go. I think maybe I'm going to come here. You're going to see the back of my head because I want to see this and straighten out the wing a little bit. Here. And down. One blackbird. Fighting. Clean up a little bit here. Now that's one cherubim. So we'll leave him. If anything, I was going to maybe dip in my glaze here, go back into the flesh tone, a little yellow ochre and a tiny bit of white. Maybe we will put the other arm in like this. Watch out, you don't want to pick up the black tones. The old Italian way, Da Vinci and the masters, they put green down. Chromium green and chromium oxide green. Very expensive. And they use lead white. Well, of course, we don't use that anymore, lead white. But here we have the baby a little bit. I'm going to go into the raw sienna a little bit and the burnt sienna, a little bit of the brown for the back one. And just put this one in. Because what I'm going to do is, I think I'm going to put a spear. The baby holding a spear. Well, we don't have to do that now. We're going to put the next blackbird in. So, go clean, keep your three brushes in a nice container. This is actually a spice container. And I just put terpenoid in there so I can keep the brushes clean as I go back and forth with the details. So I'm going to put another blackbird in. So look, everything is facing left on this particular. So let's look at another photo here and see if we can get one facing the opposite way. I always use references. It's hard when you, I mean, some people naturally know bird structure, but I don't study birds all the time. So we're going to put one. We got to think of our composition. So I'm going to put one here. Bear with me. Can use the chalk on this one. I think here we're going to put one. And the wings will go like that here. Here, we're going to put the off the page. And here, we're going to do shorter. It's about 10. And we're going to put another baby here. This cherub baby is going to be fighting as usual. On the bird. This is how we're going to put this one, I think. Maybe a little bit like this. We'll see. Let's try it. Can't get it in because it's a little. So I'm going to go back into the glaze a little bit. First put the baby in. See if I can get him in with his big head. Put his back in. His arms. Fat. Back fat. Leg. One leg going this way. He's sitting sideways. So I wouldn't worry too much about it. And his leg is here. So we're going to dip into the terpenoid again. Get a little bit of the titanium white. Make sure you have that glaze medium on so we both can work on this oil painting today. There's his back. There's the baby's head. And there's the arm. This one's going to be holding a spear too, so he's fighting. They're fighting the four horsemen. These are angels. These are my interpretation. A little bit more glaze of angels. Baby got a fat back, an arm here. Make the head a little bigger. That always gives it a baby feeling. And the fat arms. So, and then we have the leg. I wouldn't worry too much about the leg. Probably put the foot like that, a little foreshortening. There's our second baby in our bird. little bit more. I dipped and cleaned in the terpenoid, and I put in a little flesh tone. Don't forget, dip in your medium so you can get this cherub in here. Arm, shoulder, head, and the other arm. This is a little bit of a foreshortening here, so there we go. We have another baby. Foot, leg, tush. There we go. The medium helps. So we have another bird. I'm sorry. Another baby on a blackbird, my favorite bird. We're going to go and get a clean brush with a point and put our blackbird in. I might adjust it a little bit because of the head. I want the head to show here. The beak. And then we're going to change the wing pattern because I want it here. A little bit off. It's okay. Bring it off. We don't have to show this part because of the baby's foot. The baby's foot's going to be there. You know anything about birds, I watch them a lot, but they do have that shoulder here, so I wanted to put that shoulder in here behind the baby's foot maybe, and pointing out the longest feather is here. So we're going to put the baby's tush here, then we're going to go to this side and put the shoulder in. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. So basically, we have our second blackbird. We're going to shorten the tail a little bit, and the bird, he's flying this way. That's another warrior, another angel warrior on this bird, carrying the cherub angel. My favorite blackbird. Watch what I'm doing. Okay. Another one. Warriors. I'm going to put this one here. And I'm going to bring this wing over. Yeah. There you go. And big tushy on that bird. Go back into a little bit of that white. All right, so now we have two blackbirds and two angels. I'm going to move it a little bit up like that. Put it back in. Terpenoid, get my other brush. See if we have this anatomically correct. We should dip in your medium. You should have a nice thigh here coming up. And of course, the leg and the toes. So we might put a little bit more black in there. So far, so good. Put it back into the terpenoid, that brush. Go back in for the black. And just, because it is a thigh, we're going to bring it like that. So we're going to bring this part out. Hide that part. And bring that thigh like that. And that's okay. Probably gonna go like that. Yeah. Black. All right. We'll fix that. Adjust it. We're gonna put wings on too. So right now we'll just get the babies in. I'm sorry, the angels. A little bit of spread here. A little bit lighter. I'm gonna put it on heavier here. And we're going to soften. Right now, I'm not shading as much as I'm getting them in. So I'm just going to thin out some of the paint with the corner of this brush, as you can see. Get that baby in. And what we do need to do, oh, hot dog. We need to change this blackbird because the butt's going to be here. On this one, see? And then we'll just go like that for that one. here too. Flat and up and here for the thigh. There you go. We're going to put wings on the back too. We can always adjust things. That's what's great about oils. Let's go back into our medium here. And I think maybe bring that butt out. And then soften. Just as long as we get them in a little bit right now. All right. Let's check this out. A little glaze. I think we're going to extend the body here and the butt. Yeah, I like that. And change that. So here we go again. But it's okay. I wanted to change it. I'm putting some ivory back. We can only do so much with that bird underneath. So clean your brush. Swipe it clean. Dip it in the glaze. Go back into the titanium white. Go back into the flesh tone. Put a little bit of that yellow ochre in. I like the baby's pink. That's why I'm using the flesh tone. But typically I don't use flesh tones. And we should call them angels because that's what they are now. And I like babies to be a little bit of pink because they are pink. So that's why I'm using a flesh tone instead of mixing my tones today. And that's okay. So we have two babies on two blackbirds. This one's in the foreground. It's bigger. And that one's a little bit back. So that's good. Put it back in your terpenoid to sit. That's my glaze. We're going to put another baby and bird in. I think here, let's take the black and let's make this one here and here. We'll do it like that and then the tail. He's going to be a little smaller. We're going to put the baby in now. So I'm going to go back into the glaze medium so we can work this. It does take about a week for an oil to dry completely. That's why I like this glaze medium for oils. It helps you work. We're going to put the baby in now. I think standing. I think I like the fact that she's going to be standing. A watch, big head, babies have big heads, and of course, maybe too big of a head. We might take a little out, so let's do this. If you're watching, go back in with a little bit of that black and glaze. It's actually the purple, so let's take our happy index finger. Dip it in some terpenoid, index fingers. Thank God for them. And let's just take out this part a little bit here. And that part a little bit. We're going to backtrack here. Just going to shorten it a little bit. And then I'm going to do this. Go back in. Chubby baby. Fighting baby, or I'm sorry, we have to call them angels. They're angels, lady. Yeah. They're angels. And this is the back, so I'm not sure if I'm going to give it a face here. Maybe I will, or maybe show the back. I kind of like it standing back, so I'm going to put it like this. There's little feet here for now. Dip in your glaze, rumpus, legs. I'm going to go like that on that leg. Yeah. A little bit here, stomach, arms, chubby arms, babies, angels, chubbies, and here. I like this one. So now we have three angels. I dipped in the glaze again to keep it workable. knee, chubby butt, foot. So let's go in here, a little bit more flesh for the butt. Butt sticking out here. And the knee, it's probably gonna be like that. There we go. This one's standing on the bird. I'll go back into the terpenoid and get a brush that's clean, dip into the black, and take it out here. And here. Gotta put a separation in there. Right? Chubby butt in here. We're gonna break this out a little bit more. We'll just put sideways and sideways here, and there's the bird. This is a standing angel, if you can see, on our blackbird. Dip for some, and then we're just gonna put that tail here. I think I'll just take that part out here, but that's okay. I don't mind. You can reverse like this. Just take a little bit of the terpenoid. Reverse. And I want the wing to go another way. He's standing up. And I'm going to take this part off. I want the wing here. Maybe even shorter. Or longer because he's flying up. So we'll probably change that. I don't mind. And here, yeah. Maybe here, because he's flying up. So we go back in. And I'm slowly going around that foot of the cherub. And in here. And we're going to put the wings in. I think here. We'll just go like that. Here, I think we'll show a little bit of contrast and show the bird's head and the beak pointing up. Maybe take out a little bit here. It's flying up. You can always take out. So I just take my index finger again. I dip a little in the terpenoid. And I think I'm going to reverse this a little and make the wing go that way. See how I can do that? That looks better. And like that. Take out a little bit here. That does look better. See? Go into the black. Here you go. They're intersecting wings. I don't mind that. Off the page or off the canvas in this case. It creates interest because the viewer, you invite your viewer in and your viewer will actually finish the scenario. Now we got our baby. And I'm just going to make the head look a little bigger. And like that. Maybe more here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Intersection. It's fine. Even if we shorten it a little. Okay. Now we can work on those details too later. At least we got our next bird in. 3 fighting angels. So we have one more angel to do. If I turn it, if you can see. Probably work on this one over here. Orion. The constellation is going to be in between these two birds and the cherubs. I am going to put wings on my angels. And, brush came apart. The last one. So I might adjust this one too here. Probably need it more like this. And then the top of the bird looks a little bit better. It's a blackbird. And remember, I always say babies have Flintstone feet. They have Flintstone feet. They're so big. So there we have that. That's a little bit better. Probably we'll change this part for the tush. And just give them that side view. There we go. Okay. Don't worry about highlights now. We just want to get in the four cherubs today, if you can see. And the blackbirds, because they're fighting the horse and the skeletons. One more. And we're going to put this one flying. Let's take this chalk out I put in because it is a little confusing for me today. So I'm going to put the bird in first. We have one, two, three, and we want four. So let's do a profile sideways with this bird. And just going to go off the page. They're close. We're going to bring it like this. Probably could bring it further and not have them intersecting. I think I'm going to change that. Take your index finger, bring it out. I think I'm going to change this one. I'm not too worried about it. I'm going to go back in. I'm going to make changes. I think I'm going to leave him here and here for the shoulders. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. And then back into the black. And then the cherub is going to be here. So before I finish this bird going off the page, I think we'll just adjust the wings a little bit. Go back in, take your index finger, just change it a little here and here. I love this first bird and cherub, so we're going to turn it sideways and put the baby in. So let's get our glaze. Let's dip into our glazing medium. A little bit of titanium white. And this cherub's, this actual angel is going to be, again, standing. Short legs, big bottoms, belly, a bubbly back. All cherubs have it. Maybe drop it down a little bit more here. Take this in a little bit here. And he will be fighting. His arm up higher, shoulder, the other arm, fat old baby, and then the head. We put them right in front of. We could drop them down a little bit, but I think the composition moves around and you want flow when you're working on a piece. You want composition's important. And you want the flows for the eye. I think this one's okay, even though I cut out the hoof on this one. But I don't mind the cherub. So I'm going to bring the arm like this on this one. Bring his back like this. And bring his leg in. Bring his stomach in a little. And this leg's going to be here. This leg will be in front. That's the back leg. There's the stomach. Because both arms are going to be holding the spear. Foreshortened. And this, well, the spear should be going the other way. So let's try this. I think we'll keep this arm back a little bit here. That shoulder showing. We're going to put it in the terpenoid, that nice flesh tone. I'm going to come in with the black. And I think we'll take away with the index finger. We're just going to take away this one. I'm going to show the hoof a little bit more. The horse's hoof. and the arm here. So I'm going to pull it out a little bit. Like that. So we can still see that part. Go back in with my flesh tone and put his arms like this. And this arm like that. So we have the thigh, the belly, the shoulder, the arm. You can see the wing too here. We're going to do it like that. Yeah, that's fine. So back into the titanium. This is the thigh here. The belly, the baby's buns, back leg. Yeah, this one's going to be in front. That one's going to be in back, sitting on the, watch how I do the feet, and then the arm like this, and then the shoulders, and a bigger head. Always a bigger head. Okay, we have four angels. Just gonna keep it smooth. Dip in the glaze. Put in the four angels, cherubs, babies, like that. I like this one. That one came out pretty good, pretty fast. I'm not always this lucky. Nobody is. Okay. This one, a little bit more titanium white here in the back. And we'll just fade that out later. His knee, back of his head. And if you look, I can put in some pink for the spine, shoulder. And dip into the glaze. Swipe your brush clean. Let's get some more glaze on here. It always smooths it out, see? Shoulder. Just going to go a little bit here, more. Here. I like it smooth, though, so. And then we're not going to worry about this. I don't know why I put this in right away, because we're going to change that spear or sword or whatever that we just haven't decided what we're going to do. And then this one. Uh-oh. Hope you can see here, the baby, the back. We're putting on titanium white now. Just for highlights, the babies are pink and I love the head, so this is where we're going to do it now. Shoulder, thigh. I'm going to dip in and give a little bit more of that beautiful flesh tone in oils. Back into the flesh tone. And a little bit of the highlights for the rumpus. Mm-hmm. Yep. I love babies. Who doesn't love babies? They're so adorable. Babies are little humans. A little bit of a roll here. Back of the head. Clean up that part. That part. That part. A little there. So, I think this lesson we put in, and I was showing you how to make cherubs. Babies, angels. There are baby fighting warriors, so his little rumpus is out here. Maybe a little bit too much, but that's okay. Some are chubbier than others. So, we'll just leave him like this for now. Smooth it out a little bit. I like to smooth it out. So I'll take my smaller swiper. I like to have swipers. I like to take out excess and smooth it out before I put the next tones in. So right now, I'll just wait for this baby, this medium tone to dry. I'm just smoothing it out a little bit. I might even change it in here a little bit. We'll see. Maybe extend one part, but if I get them in right now like this, I'm happy. Uh-oh, I have that black showing through. So, because we're working, it's not really been a week, it's been a day. Let's go back in here. Just put some glaze in, yeah, so we can see that one. And I don't mind that one. That's what we'll do. I'm putting in straight that beautiful flesh tone that you can get. Looks good. Not too much today. Yep. And this one I might change a little, but so far, I think he needs to come out more here. There we go. And I have this little tush. Put it back in, and I think today we're going to finish this lesson. Oh, we have to finish the blackbird there before I sign out. So let's do it like this, here and here. Put that little babies in there. And then take a little bit of that burnt sienna. It's a red brown. And we'll just give them a little bit of form today. Yeah. Maybe here and here. You don't really see that part here. It's very shadowed here and here. Chubby. Chubby baby. Here. Spine. Back of the head. There we go. And then we'll put in the wings next. I don't think we'll have time today for this lesson to have the wings, but let's go in here. There we go. Then we can put the wings. We might even do a little bit more, I think, that burnt sienna. Just a little here. You can see what I'm doing. Don't want to work too much because there's the blackbird underneath that one in here. So I like that. Dip it in glaze. Oh, get that brush clean. You don't want those muddy colors. Nope. A little bit more of the flesh tone. No muddy colors today. There you go. There you go. Swipe it a little bit. Pink. There's the spine. There's that back leg. Cherubs are in. Pretty good. Smooth them out. I think here, I'll just do the tush here. Yeah. There we go. Not bad. Here, my little warrior with the tummy, and back of the head here, and here. I think it's good for now. We can even extend this back a little because babies are chubby. Yep. All right, blackbird. Over here, it'll look nice. So don't get discouraged because we're not to details yet. So don't get discouraged at this point. We're getting everything in. I'm just going to pretend the wing goes like this and like that. We'll put it up there like that. And we'll paint it in. Again, the ivory black will go around his feet. And we have four angel cherubs. I'm going to try to get around here as you watch. feet need to be squared off as always. Oh, and the wing. I think we're good. I think we need to go like this with the shoulder though. So, uh-oh, hot dog, don't spill. I might have accentuated that a little bit too much, and we can change it. So I think today we can't really put the angel's wings in or the weapons. We still need to dry, so we'll give it some time. So the next lesson, I'm going to do detail, so don't get discouraged. We're going to do detail. We're going to put in the baby's, or I'm sorry, the cherub angel wings. And next lesson four, I believe, is going to be, yeah, there we go, a little bit like that. I could get it reversed, sometimes I do, so let's just leave it like that for now, and we'll work on that later. I'm going to get my swiper, a soft sable, and just clean it up in here, a little bit around the wings. We can even take a little terpenoid and a little black glaze, tiny bit of the cobalt. Mm-hmm. And we'll just dip it in the terpenoid and just go in here a little, even if I was going to do a little bit more cobalt. We'll just go in here a little bit. I don't mind. We can even do this. Take a little bit of the white and the cobalt, the titanium white, and just fill in some colors in here. Just like swirls. Oh, you know what it could be? Clouds. Yeah. Clouds. So we'll prepare for the clouds now. I'm excited. So we'll put in the clouds. Right now we'll leave that black. And we'll make these clouds. And in here. Well, we got the horse's leg in here too. But we don't need a lot of clouds. See, I think we're doing good. I'm going to put this one down. And I believe one swiper. Nice soft one. We're just going to go in here, maybe a bigger swipe, but that's okay. I don't mind that. Orion's going to be here, so I don't want that. We can always fix things. That was the horse's leg in the background. That's some chalk here. Chalked in some stuff. I don't mind. Let's see if we can get one more swiper. I had them. Oh, they're right here, right in front of me. I like them nice and dry and soft. So make sure it's a very soft one. This is super soft. Just a cheap brush, but it helps because I just want to smooth out. We're going to pick it up a little bit on the edge. Sticking a little. And we're just going to swipe it in here. It doesn't matter, really. I like to smooth some areas out, here, here, stay up, here, 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 and here. We have some background, the horse's background here. Get this out of here so you can see it. So we have four angels, and we're going to put in the next lesson, we're going to fix them, we're going to put in some more detail. And then we're going to put in their wings, their bodies. We're going to work on their anatomy a little bit. Then we're going to put in the wings. And then we're going to put in their weapons. And there are four blackbirds fighting. A little swipe here. See how I can kind of clean it up a little. And I can put that in again, the wings. I'm not worried about it. Here too. here. Well, here we go. Here. We'll work on this a little more. Get some of that excess paint off. I like smooth. I do technique with palettes and heavy, heavy paint, but today I like this smooth. I want the smooth look. And then in the middle, we're going to put Orion, the constellation. All right. Thank you so much for watching. Remember the four horsemen and the apocalypse skeletons, and we put in the cherubs, the angels today. And excuse me, number four, we'll be fixing the detail on the angels, the four cherubs. We'll be putting in the wings and their weapons and detail everywhere. So we're getting close to a lot of detail, and that's what it takes to do something nice. It takes fine detail in the end. Get it all in. As you can see, I made some changes in chalk from the third lesson, and I did fix some areas, the horse, so we'll be doing that too. We'll be fixing some areas, and here I did chalk in and fix. So thank you so much for watching. We'll see you for lesson four. I'm Mile, the art teacher, and this is the four horsemen of the apocalypse, and four cherubs are the warriors fighting the four horsemen. They're the good fighting evil. Thank you.